The martyrdom and ascension of Isaiah.
First and foremost,
and it came to pass in the 26th year of the reign of Hezekiah, king of Judah, that he called Manasseh his son. Now he was his only one. And he called him into the presence of Isaiah, the son of Amoz, the prophet, and into the presence of Josaph, the son of Isaiah, in order to deliver unto him the word of righteousness, which the king himself had seen, and of the eternal judgments and torments of Gehenna, and of the prince of this world, and of his angels, and his authority and his power. And the words of the faith of the beloved which he himself had seen in the 15th year of his reign during his illness. And he delivered unto him the written words which Samuel the scribe had written, and also those which Isaiah the son of Amoz had given to him, and also to the prophets, that they might write and store up with him what he himself had seen in the king's house regarding the judgment of the angels and the destruction of this world, and regarding the garments of the saints and their going forth, and regarding their transformation and the persecution and ascension of the beloved. In the 28th year of the reign of Hezekiah, Isaiah had seen the words of this prophecy and had delivered them to Josiah his son. And whilst Hezekiah gave commands, Josiah the son of Isaiah came by. Isaiah said to Hezekiah the king, but not in the presence of Manasseh only did he say unto him, "As the Lord liveth, and the Spirit which speaketh in me liveth, all these commands and these words will be made of none effect by Manasseh thy son, and through the agency of his hands I shall depart mid the torture of my body. And Samael Malkira will serve Manasseh and execute all his desire, and he will become a follower of Belial rather than of me. And many in Jerusalem and in Judea he will cause to abandon the true faith, and Belial will dwell in Manasseh, and by his hands I shall be sawn asunder." And when Hezekiah heard these words, he wept very bitterly and rent his garments, and placed earth upon his head, and fell on his face. And Isaiah said unto him, "The counsel of Samael against Manasseh is consummated, not will avail thee." And on that day Hezekiah resolved in his heart to slay Manasseh his son. And Isaiah said to Hezekiah, "The beloved hath made of none effect thy design, and the purpose of thy heart will not be accomplished. For with this calling I have been called, and I shall inherit the heritage of the beloved." And it came to pass after that Hezekiah died and Manasseh became king, that he did not remember the commands of Hezekiah his father, but forgot them. And Samael abode in Manasseh and clung fast to him. And Manasseh forsook the service of the God of his father, and he served Satan and his angels and his powers. And he turned aside the house of his father, which had been before the face of Hezekiah, from the words of wisdom and from the service of God. And Manasseh turned aside his heart to serve Belial, for the angel of lawlessness, who is the ruler of this world, is Belial, whose name is Mantabuchus. And he delighted in Jerusalem because of Manasseh, and he made him strong in apostatizing Israel, and in the lawlessness which was spread abroad in Jerusalem. And witchcraft, and magic increased, and divination, and adoration, and fornication, and adultery, and the persecution of the righteous by Manasseh, and Belkira, and Tobiah the Canaanite, and John of Anathoth, and by Zadok the chief of the works. And the rest of the acts, behold, they are written in the books of the kings of Judah and Israel. And when Isaiah, the son of Amoz, saw the lawlessness which was being perpetuated in Jerusalem, and the worship of Satan and his wantonness, he withdrew from Jerusalem and settled in Bethlehem of Judah. And there also was much lawlessness, and withdrawing from Bethlehem, he settled on a mountain in a desert place. And Micaiah the prophet, and the age of Ananias, and Joel, and Habakkuk, and his son Josaph, and many of the faithful who believed in the ascension into heaven, withdrew and settled on the mountain. They were all clothed with garments of hair, and they were all prophets, and they had nothing with them but were naked. And they all lamented with a great lamentation because of the going astray of Israel. And these eat nothing save wild herbs, which they gathered on the mountains. And having cooked them, they lived thereon together with Isaiah the prophet. And they spent 2 years of days on the mountains and hills. And after this, while they were in the desert, there was a certain man in Samaria named Belkira, of the family of Zedekiah, the son of Chenan, a false prophet, whose dwelling was in Bethlehem. Now Hezekiah, the son of Chenani, who was the brother of his father, and in the days of Ahab, king of Israel, had been the teacher of the prophet of Baal, had himself smitten and reproved Micaiah, the son of Amada, the prophet. And he, Micaiah, had been reproved by Ahab and cast into prison. And he was with Zedekiah the prophet, and they were with Ahaziah, the son of Ahab, king in Samaria. And Elijah the prophet of Tebon of Gilead was reproving Ahaziah and Samaria, and prophesied regarding Ahaziah that he should die on his bed of sickness, and that Samaria should be delivered into the hands of Nebuchadnezzar, because he had slain the prophets of God. And when the false prophets who were with Ahaziah, the son of Ahab, and their teacher Halahaz of Mount Joel had heard, now he was a brother of Zedekiah, they persuaded Ahaziah the king of Agaron, and slew Micaiah. And Belcherah recognized and saw the place of Isaiah and the prophets who were with him, for he dwelt in the region of Bethlehem, and was an adherent of Manasseh. And he prophesied falsely in Jerusalem, and many belonging to Jerusalem were confederate with him, and he was a Samaritan. And it came to pass, when Alagarzagar, king of Assyria, had come and taken them captive, and led them away to the mountains of the Medes and the rivers of Tazan, this Belcherah, while still a youth, had escaped and come to Jerusalem in the days of Hezekiah, king of Judah. But he walked not in the ways of his father of Samaria, for he feared Hezekiah. And he was found in the days of Hezekiah speaking words of lawlessness in Jerusalem. And the servants of Hezekiah accused him, and he made his escape to the region of Bethlehem, and they persuaded. And Belcherah accused Isaiah and the prophets who were with him, saying, Isaiah and those who are with him prophesy against Jerusalem, and against the cities of Judah, that they shall be laid waste, and against the children of Judah and Benjamin, and also that they shall go into captivity, and against thee also, O Lord the King, that thou shalt go bound with hooks and iron chains. But they prophesy falsely against Israel and Judah. And Isaiah himself hath said, I see more than Moses the prophet. But Moses said, no man can see God and live. And Isaiah hath said, I have seen God, and behold, I live. Know therefore, O king, that he is lying. And Jerusalem also he hath called Sodom, and the princes of Judah and Jerusalem he hath declared to be the people of Gomorrah. And he brought many accusations against Isaiah and the prophets before Manasseh. But Beliar dwelt in the heart of Manasseh, and in the heart of the princes of Judah and Benjamin, and of the eunuchs, and of the counselors of the king. And the words of Belcherah pleased him exceedingly, and he sent and seized Isaiah. For Beliar was in great wrath against Isaiah by reason of the vision, and because of the exposure wherewith he has exposed Samael, and because through him the going forth of the Beloved from the seventh heaven had been made known, and his transformation, and his descent, and the likeness into which he should be transformed, that is, the likeness of man, and the persecution wherewith he should be persecuted, and the torturers wherewith the children of Israel should torture him, and the coming of his 12 disciples, and the teaching, and that he should, before the Sabbath, be crucified upon the tree, and should be crucified together with wicked men, and that he should be buried in the sepulcher, and the 12 who were with him should be offended because of him, and the watch of those who watch the sepulcher, and the descent of the angel of the Christian church, which is in the heavens, whom he will summon in the last days, and that Gabriel, the angel of the Holy Spirit, and Michael, the chief of the holy angels, on the third day will open the sepulcher, and the Beloved, sitting on their shoulders, will come forth and send out his 12 disciples, and they will teach all the nations and every tongue of the resurrection of the Beloved. And those who believe in his cross will be saved, and in his ascension into the seventh heaven whence he came. And that many who believe in him will speak through the Holy Spirit. And many signs and wonders will be wrought in those days. And afterwards, on the eve of his approach, his disciples will forsake the teachings of the 12 apostles, and their faith, and their love, and their purity. And there will be much contention on the eve of his advent and his approach. And in those days many will love office, though devoid of wisdom. Now, and there will be many lawless elders and shepherds dealing wrongly by their own sheep, and they will ravage them owing to their not having holy shepherds. And many will change the honor of the garments of the saints for the garments of the covetous, And there will be much right respected persons in those days, and lovers of the honor of this world. Saying,
you know,
and there will be much slander and vainglory at the approach of the Lord, and the Holy Spirit will withdraw from many. And there will not be in those days many prophets, nor those who speak trustworthy words, save one here and there in diverse places. On account of the spirit of error and fornication, and of vainglory and of covetousness, which shall be in those who will be called the servants of that one, and those who will receive that one. And there will be great hatred in the shepherds and elders towards each other, and there will be great jealousy in the last days, for everyone will say what is pleasing in his own eyes. And they will make of none effect the prophecy of the prophets which were before me, and these my visions also will they make of none effect, in order to speak after the impulse of their own hearts. And now Hezekiah and Josaph my son, these are the days of the completion of the world. After it is consummated, Belial, the great ruler, the king of this world, will descend, who hath ruled it since it came into being. Yea, he will descend from his firmament in the likeness of a man, a lawless king, the slayer of his mother, who himself even is this king, will persecute the plant which the 12 apostles of the beloved have planted. Of the 12, one will be delivered into his hands. This ruler in the form of that king will come, and there will come with him all the powers of this world, and they will hearken unto him all that he desires. And at his word the sun will rise at night, and he will make the moon to appear at the sixth hour. And all that he hath desired he will do in the world, and he will do and speak like the beloved, and he will say, I am God, and before me there has been none. And all the people of the world will believe in him, and they will sacrifice to him, and they will serve him, saying, this is God, and besides him there is no other. And the greater number of those who shall have been associated together in order to receive the beloved, he will turn aside after him. And there will be the power of his miracle in every city and region. And he will set up his image before him in every city. And he shall bear sway 3 years and 7 months and 27 days. And many believers and saints, having seen him for whom they were hoping, he was crucified, Jesus, the Lord Christ. After that, I, Isaiah, had seen him who was crucified and ascended, and those who were believers in him. Of these few, in those days, will be left as his servants, while they flee from desert to desert, awaiting the coming of the beloved. After 1,332 days, the Lord will come with his angels, and with the armies of the holy ones from the seventh heaven, with the glory of the seventh heaven. And he will drag Belial into Gehenna, and also his army. And he will give the rest of the godly whom he shall find in the body in this world, and the son will be ashamed. And to all who, because of their faith in him, have execrated Belial and his king. But the saints will come with the Lord, with their garments, which are now stored up on high in the seventh heaven. With the Lord they will come, whose spirits are clothed. They will descend and be present in this world. And he will strengthen those who have been found in the body, together with the saints, in the garments of the saints. And the Lord will minister to those who have kept watch in this world. And afterwards, they will turn themselves upward in their garments, and their body will be left in the world. Then the voice of the beloved will, in wrath, rebuke the things of heaven, and the things of the earth, and the things of the earth, and the mountains, and the hills, and the cities, and the desert, and the forests, and the angel of the sun, and that of the moon, and all things wherein Belial manifested himself, and acted openly in this world. And there will be a resurrection and a judgment in their midst in those days. And the beloved will cause fire to go forth from him. And it will consume all the godless, and they will be as though they had not been created. And the rest of the words of the vision are written in the vision of Babylon. And the rest of the vision regarding the Lord, behold, it is written in three parables according to my words, which are written in the book which I publicly prophesied. And the descent of the beloved is sealed. Behold, it is written in the section where the Lord says, so, behold, my son will
we understand in spirit that
and all these things,
all
behold,
the
they
the
are written
Lord,
in the Psalms, who have in the parables of
word.
David, the son of Jesse,
right?
And in the prophets of Solomon,
the Most
son,
High, right?
And in the words of Korah, and in the words of Asaph, and in the rest of the Psalms also, which the angel of the Spirit inspired. Namely,
right?
In those which
but
have not the name
also
written, and in the words of my father Amos,
their word.
And of Hosea
so
the prophet, and of Micah,
songs.
And Joel, and
right.
Nahum, and Jonah, and Obadiah, and Habakkuk, and Haggai, and Malachi, and in the words of Joseph the just, and in the words of Daniel.
All right, we're going to rejoice.
On account of these visions, therefore, Bilyar was wroth with Isaiah, and he dwelt in the heart of Manasseh, and he sawed him asunder with a wooden saw. And when Isaiah was being sawn in sunder, Belkira stood up, accusing him, and all the false prophets stood up, laughing and rejoicing because of Isaiah. And Belkira, with the aid of Mech and Becher, stood up before Isaiah, laughing and deriding. And Belkira said to Isaiah, "Say, I have lied in all that I have spoken, and likewise the ways of Manasseh are good and right, and the ways also of Bakira and of his associates are good." And this he said to him when he began to do this on asunder. But Isaiah was absorbed in a vision of the Lord, and though his eyes were open, he saw him not.
But Bakira spake thus to Isaiah,
"Say what I say unto you, and I will turn your hearts. And I will compel Manasseh and the princes of Judah and the people and all Jerusalem to reverence
their
And Isaiah answered and said, "So far as I have uttered, I say, stand, and accuse me thou and all thy powers and all thy house. But thou canst not take from me aught save the skin of my body." And they seized and sawed in sunder Isaiah, the son of Amoz, with a wooden saw. And Manasseh and Belkira and the false prophets and the princes and the people and all stood looking on. And to the prophets who were with him, he said before he had been sawn in sunder, "Go ye to the region of Tyre and Sidon, for for me only hath God mingled the cup." And when Isaiah was being sawn in sunder, he neither cried aloud nor wept aloud, but his lips spake with the Holy Spirit until he was sawn in twain. This Bilyar did to Isaiah through Belkira and Manasseh, for Samael was very wrathful against Isaiah from the days of Hezekiah, king of Judah, on account of the things which he had seen. And on account of the destruction of Samael, which he had seen through the Lord, while Hezekiah his father was still king. And he did according to the will of Satan. The vision which Isaiah the son of Amoz saw.
In a sense, a lot of people will take
in the 20th year of the reign of Hezekiah, king of Judah, came Isaiah the son of Amoz, and Josiah the son of Isaiah to Hezekiah to Jerusalem from Gilgala. And having entered, he sat down on the couch of the king, and brought him a seat, but he would not sit thereon. And when Isaiah began to speak the words of faith and truth to King Hezekiah, all the princes of Israel were seated, and the eunuchs, and
does
the counselors,
that mean that they're
going to
lose their rank and order?
And there were there 40 prophets and sons of the
Revelation
prophets.
20.
They had come from the villages and from the mountains and the plains where they had heard that Isaiah was coming from Gilgala to Hezekiah.
Right.
And they came to salute him and to hear his words, and that he might place his hands upon them, and that they might prophesy, and that he might hear their prophecies. And they were all
at my table with me.
And when Isaiah was speaking to Hezekiah the words of truth and faith, they all heard a door which one had opened, and the voice of the Holy Spirit. And the king summoned all the prophets and all the people who were found there, and they came. And Micaiah and the aged Ananias and Joel and Joseph sat on the right hand and on the left. And it came to pass when they had all heard the voice of the Holy Spirit, they all worshipped on their knees and glorified the God of truth, the Most High, who is in the upper world and who sits on high,
the
Holy One, who rests among his holy ones.
All right, the men.
And they gave glory to him who had thus bestowed his door in an alien world and
had
bestowed it on
man.
And as he was speaking in the Holy Spirit,
and when
Yahweh
was on earth,
he became silent, and his mind was taken up from him.
Right,
and he saw not the men
him,
that stood before
well.
Him, though his eyes indeed were open. Moreover, his lips were silent, and the mind in his body was taken up from him.
All right.
But his breath was
so
in
that's
him,
why
for he was seeing
in
a vision.
John, the 17th chapter,
and the angel who was sent to make him see was not of this firmament. Nor was he of the angels of the glory of this world, but he had come from the seventh heaven. And the people who stood near did not think, but the circle of prophets did, that the holy Isaiah had been taken up. And the vision which the holy Isaiah saw was not from this world, but from the world which is hidden from the flesh. And after Isaiah had seen this
vision,
he narrated it
says,
in time, and to Joseph his son, and to the other
and
prophets who had come.
Set upon them,
but the leaders and the eunuchs and the people did not hear, but only
and I
Samuel
saw the souls
of Joseph
of them that were
Asaph
beheaded
the
for the witness of Yahweh,
for these
God,
also
the
were
word
of righteousness,
God, which
and the
not
sweet smell of
the
Spirit was upon
neither
them.
His image,
but the people had not heard,
had
for Micaiah and Joseph his son caused them to go forth, when the wisdom of this world had been taken from him, and he became as one dead. And the vision which Isaiah saw, he told of Hezekiah and Josiah his son, and Micaiah, and the rest of the prophets he said.
No, this be,
at this
these
moment,
men,
when I prophesied, okay, according to the word which he heard,
be directly
I saw a glorious
with
angel, not like right, unto the glory of the angels which I used on earth to see, but possessing such glory and position that I cannot describe the glory of that angel. And having seized me by my hand, he raised me on high, and I said unto him, who art thou, and what is thy name?
Lord willing,
and whither art thou raising
me on
high? For strength was given me to speak
but
with
I would love to be
and he said unto
one of those who
when I
have
raised
with
thee on high, through the various degrees, and made thee to see the vision, on account of which I have been sent, then thou wilt understand who I am, but my name thou dost not know, because thou wilt return unto this body. But whither I am raising thee on high, thou wilt see. But for this purpose have I been sent. And I rejoiced because he spake courteously to thee. And he said unto me, hast thou rejoiced because I have spoken courteously to thee? And he said, and thou wilt see how a greater than I am will also speak courteously and peaceably with me. And his father also, who is greater, wilt thou see. But for this purpose I have been sent from the seventh heaven, in order to explain all these things unto thee. And we ascended to the firmament. I am, and there I saw Samael and his host,
right?
And there was great fighting
light
there,
shines in
and
us.
The angels of Satan were envying one another. And as above, so on earth also,
away,
for the likeness of that which is in the firmament
mark
is here on
how
earth.
Are they with
and I said unto the angel who was with
right,
me, what is this war, and what is this
war? Those who are left on
and he said unto me, so has it been since the world was made until now,
away,
and this war will continue. Till he whom thou shalt see will come and destroy
this brings
him.
To life the point.
And afterwards, he caused me to ascend
that
to that which
Revelation
is above the firmament,
chapter,
which is the first heaven.
Okay, in the,
and there I saw a throne in the midst,
read it again,
and on his right and on his
verse,
left were angels.
And I heard a voice
and the angels on the left
the
were not like unto the angels who stood
written
on the right. But those who stood on the right,
right
had the greater glory.
The
and they all praised with one voice. And there was a throne in the midst. And those who were on the left gave praise after them. But their voice was not such as the voice of those on the right, nor their praise like the praise of those on the right. And I asked the angel who conducted me, and I said unto him, to whom is this praise sent? And he said unto me, it is sent to the praise of him who sitteth in the seventh heaven, to him who rests in the whole world, and to his beloved, whence I have been sent to thee, thither is it sent. And again he made me to ascend to the second heaven. Now the height of that heaven was the same as from the heavens to the earth and to the firmament. And I saw there, as in the first heaven, angels on the right and on the left, and a throne in the midst, and the praise of the angels in the second heaven. And he who sat on the throne in the second heaven was more glorious than all the rest. And there was great glory in the second heaven. And the praise was also not like the praise of those who were in the first
Adam
heaven. And I fell on my face to worship him.
Right.
But the angel who conducted me did not permit
so
me.
In
and he said unto me, worship
alive.
Neither throne nor angel,
right,
which belongs to the sixth heaven. Before this cause I was sent to conduct thee, until I tell thee in the seventh heaven. For above all the heavens and their angels have thy throne been placed, and thy garments and thy crown which thou shalt see.
Okay.
And I rejoice with great joy that those who love the Most High and
his
beloved will afterwards ascend thither by the angel of the Holy Spirit. And he raised me to the third heaven. And in like manner I saw those upon the right and upon the left. And there was a throne there in the midst. But the memorial of this world is
that
there
which has been arranged, things placed
and I said
in order,
to the angel
body of soldiers,
for the glory of my
band,
appearance was undergoing transformation as I ascended
order,
to each heaven in turn.
Right?
Nothing of the vanity of that world is here.
But
named.
Every man in his own
and he answered
order,
me and said unto me, nothing
is
named
that
on account
is the
of weakness, and nothing
now,
is hidden
the
there of what is done.
Read Revelation 14,
and I wish to learn how it is known. And he answered
word
me, saying,
for the 144,
when I have raised thee to the seventh heaven whence I was sent, to that which
okay
is above thee, then
and
thou shalt know
that
there is nothing
hidden
from the throne,
that is coming,
from
so that's
those
the
who
order,
dwell in the heavens, and from the angels.
Okay.
And the praise
the
wherewith they praise, and the glory
they
of him who sat on the throne was great. And the glory
okay
of the angels on the right
then
hand and on the
end,
left was beyond that of the heaven which was
right
below
when he shall have delivered up the
and
kingdom
again,
of God, even the Father, when we...
And the height from the
when
earth,
he shall have put down all rule and authority
of power,
he's going to take down all of these.
And there again,
so,
I saw those who were on the right hand, and
those
who were
on the left. 14,
and him who sat on the throne was in the midst.
All right, Revelation 14 and 4, 144, call the Lord all our Shemeshah. These are they which were not defiled with women.
And again, the glory of him who sat on the throne was greater than that of the angels on the right. And their glory was beyond that of those who were below.
All right,
and he raised
grown men who were out preaching.
And again, I saw those upon the right hand and on the left, and him who sat on the throne, possessing greater glory than those in the fourth heaven. And the glory of those on the right hand was greater than those on the left, from the third to the fourth. And the glory of him who was on the throne was greater than that of the angels on the right hand.
They're covered under that
and their praise was more glorious than that of the fourth heaven.
All right.
And I praised him who is not named,
these are they
the only begotten who dwelleth in the heavens,
whose
name is not
known
to any flesh,
okay?
Who has bestowed such glory on the several heavens,
being
and
the
who makes great the glory
unto
of the
God
angels,
and, unto the
and
Lamb.
More excellent the glory of him who sitteth on the throne. And again, he raised me into the air of the sixth heaven, and I saw such glory as I had not seen in the five heavens. For I saw angels possessing great glory, and the praise there was holy and wonderful. And I said to the angel who conducted me, what is this which I see, my Lord? And he said, I am not thy Lord, but thy fellow servant. And again I asked him, and I said unto him, why are there not angelic fellow servants on the left? And he said, from the sixth heaven there are no longer angels on the left, nor a throne set in the midst, but they are directed by the power of the seventh heaven. Where dwelleth he that is not named?
All right,
elect,
but it says,
whose name
person
not
superior
in
excellence to
and
others
none
of
the
same class.
Learn
we're all Israelites. We're all going to get
the
reward.
For it is he alone who hears
right,
voice, all the heavens and
the rank,
give answer.
Order of that.
I have therefore been
right,
power and sent to raise thee here that thou mayest see this glory.
Now,
and that thou mayest see the Lord of all
down,
those heavens and these thrones, undergoing successive transformation until he resembles your form
and
likeness.
And in their mouth was found no guile.
Indeed, I say unto thee, Isaiah, no man
there
about to return into the body of that world
has
extended or
so
seen what thou seest, but perceived what thou hast perceived, and what thou wilt see. For it has been permitted to thee and the lot of the world to come hither, and from thence comes the power of the sixth heaven and of the air.
Okay.
And I magnified my Lord with praise, in that through his lot I should come hither. And he said, here, furthermore, therefore, this also from thy fellow servant. When from the body, by the will of God, thou hast ascended hither, then thou wilt receive the garment which thou seest, and likewise other numbered garments laid up there thou wilt see. And then thou wilt become equal to the angels of the seventh heaven. And he raised me up into the sixth heaven. And there were no angels on the left, nor a throne in the midst, but all had one opinion.
He said, write this. Why do you think he said, write this? So we can be comforted by
me also. And I also
blessed
praise
are the dead which die,
and angel also.
All right,
and
in the Lord from
theirs.
Henceforth.
And there they all
yea,
name the final
the Spirit
Father,
that they
beloved,
may rest
the Christ,
from
and
their
the Holy
labors.
Spirit, all with one voice.
All right,
and their
voice
was not like the voice of the angels in the
following.
Heaven,
what does that mean? Their
nor
words
their
discourse. They're going to get
the
their
voice
reward
was there.
For who they
and there
were,
was much
they
light
were,
there.
Who they are.
And then, when I was in the sixth
they were chosen
heaven,
from the foundation
I thought
of the earth for
a
particular rank
in
order within the heavenly fathers.
And I rejoiced and praised him who had bestowed such lights on those who wait for his promise.
Go simply to
and I besought the angel who conducted me that I should not henceforth return to the carnal
the,
world. I say unto you, Hezekiah and Josaph,
day,
my son, and Micaiah, that there
right?
is much darkness here. And the angel who conducted me discovered what
them,
I thought and said, if in this light thou dost
like
rejoice, how much more wilt thou rejoice
the
when
number.
In the seventh heaven thou seest the light?
Just
because
they're not
there
here,
the Lord,
they're not a part of the
beloved,
number.
Whence I have been sent, who is to be called
so,
son in this
because
world.
We don't see
not
all
yet
these large
multitudes of
numbers
that be in the corruptible
1,
world,
44,
and the garments,
just link
and the thrones,
with any goddamn
and
body.
The crowns which are laid
people
up for the righteous,
our,
for those who trust in that Lord, who will descend in your form. For the life
openly
is there,
denying
great,
the
Hawashah,
openly denying the middle
and
of the Lord, taking books of the Bible,
the
putting doubt
that
in
day
Israel,
not
getting paid off.
Here. And when I heard that, I was troubled.
And join so, unto them, man.
Do not be troubled.
You out of your damn mind.
And he took
man.
Me into the air of the seventh heaven. All
right, this is
and moreover, I heard a voice saying,
4 and 13,
how far
I
will
have
be
you,
sin that dwelleth
I would
in
not
flesh,
have you ignorant, brethren, concerning
trembled.
Them which are asleep.
And when I trembled, behold, I heard
all right.
from hence another voice being sent forth and
that
saying,
you sorrow not
it
even
is permitted
others which have no hope. See, those men who are making those statements, they don't really have any hope.
And I asked the angel who was with me and said, who is he who forbade me? Water who is down he who permitted me to ascend? And he said unto me, he who forbade me is the one who owes the praise giving of the sixth heaven. And he who permitted thee is thy Lord God, the Lord Christ, who will be called Jesus in the world. But his name thou canst not hear till thou hast ascended out of that body. And he raised me up into the seventh heaven, and I saw there a wonderful light, and angels innumerable. And there I saw the holy Abel and all the righteous. And there I saw Enoch and all who were with him, stripped of the garments of the flesh. Okay. And I saw them in their garments of the upper world, and they were like angels standing there in great glory. And there I saw Enoch and all who were with him, stripped of the garments of the flesh. And I saw them in their garments of the upper world, and they were like angels standing there in great glory. But they sat not in their thrones, nor were their crowns of glory on them. And I asked the angel who was with me, how is it that they have received the garments, but have not the throne and the crown? And he said unto me, crowns and thrones of glory they do not receive, so the beloved will descend in the form in which you see him descend. I will descend, I say, into the world in the last days, says the Lord, who will be called Christ.
Let's read this in
nevertheless,
NLT.
They see and know and now, whose dear, will be the throne, and whose crown is when he has descended and been made in the form. And they will think that he is flesh and is a man. And the God of that world will stretch forth his hand against the Son. And they will crucify
and
him
you
on
had
the tree,
women who
and will slay him, not knowing
there
who he is.
Weeping when Yahweh and thus
his descent,
lied
as
on,
will, see,
on that.
Will be hidden
those
even from the heavens, so that it will not be known who he is. And when he hath plundered
now,
the angel
not their
of
job
death,
to go out
he will ascend
and,
on the third
and
day,
lead the nation
and he will
of Israel,
remain in that world 545 days.
But they have a very
days.
Important
and then
order
many
of
the righteous will ascend with him. These spirits do not receive their garments, so the Lord Christ ascends.
And they're
going to
be returned to that, man.
Then indeed they will receive
now,
their garments and thrones
it
and
says,
crowns,
and, now, brothers
and he has
sisters,
ascended into the seventh heaven.
All right, we want you
and I said
to
unto him, that which
will
I
happen
asked him
to
in the third heaven,
the believers who
show
have
me
died,
how everything which is done in that world
so
is
you not
made known.
Like people who have
and whilst
no hope,
I was still speaking
you have no
with
hope,
him,
don't you
behold,
understand.
One of the angels who stood
now, all right,
more glorious
now,
than the glory
built
of that
up,
angel,
all right, and come to understand it, but a lot of you are just proud.
But not as a
and the same thing that Yahweh Shai went through, we have to go through.
And the book was written. But
like,
not
who are these
the
niggas to say they're the leaders and we got
to
come up under him
and
they're the sons of God?
The deeds of the children of Israel were written therein, and the deeds of those whom I know not, my sons.
Verse 14, for if we believe
said,
that Yahweh Shai died
truth,
and
there is nothing
again,
hidden
even
in the seventh
them also
heaven,
which
is done in
Yahweh Shai, will God.
And I saw there
them.
Many garments laid up, and many thrones, and many crowns. And I said to the angels, whose are
all we have to do is just do the work because we have no idea. We don't know. First of all,
these
we don't
garments
know
many from that
world
will receive,
doing
believing
doing
in the
don't
words
have a
that
camera
one
does have
shall
a camera.
Be named as I told thee, and they will observe those
second
things
of all,
and believe
miracles
in
are
gonna
be done
and believe
and,
in his
man,
cross,
gonna be all
for
types
them
of people
be
trying to get
up.
Down. Now, a lot
and I saw
of them
a certain one standing, whose glory surpassed that of all, and his glory was great and wonderful.
You know, they're gonna be
and after I had
phone.
Seen him, all the righteous whom I had seen, and also
okay.
the angels whom I had seen,
and all
came
you
to
have,
him,
hey, you can, you
and
can,
Adam, and Abel,
just,
and Seth, and all
you know,
the righteous
confess,
first drew near and worshipped him,
and, be
and they all praised
the
him in one voice, and I myself also gave praise
thing.
With him. And my giving and
right.
praise was as theirs.
But that'll happen in its time.
And then all the angels drew nigh and
worshiped
and
gave praise. All right, now we believe the elect are pretty much sealed.
And I was again
understand
transformed
that things are going to happen coming down
like
the
angel.
Pipe. We even gave sin.
And the angel who conducted me said to me, worship this one. And I worshiped and praised.
Gang
and the angel said unto me,
openly scoffing,
this is the Lord of all.
All right, be a demon right now. Well, something's going to happen at some
and
point.
And while he was still speaking,
like,
I saw another glorious one.
I need to stop. These are, you know?
And the righteous do not and worship and praise.
So let's
and
read
I
this again. We believe that Yahweh
Shai
died
glory
and
was not
again,
transformed
even
in accordance with
so
their form.
Them also which
and thereupon the angels drew near and worshiped him. And I saw the Lord and the second angel, and they were standing. And the second whom I saw
for
was on the left of my Lord.
This
and I
we
asked,
say unto you
who is
by the
this?
Word of the
and
Lord,
he said unto
that
me,
we which are alive and remain
for he
unto
is the
coming
angel
of the
of
Lord
the
shall
Spirit,
not prevent them which
in
are asleep.
And the rest
that
of the righteous.
Cuts you off.
And I saw the great glory.
So who
the
knows how many of them already
opened,
be up there?
And I could not thereupon see.
Think about that.
Nor yet could the angel who was with me. Nor
all
the angels
of the 144
whom I had seen
ain't gonna be on the earth. when Yahweh shall return, some will be on the chariot. All of the large multitude ain't going to be on
the earth. My Lord drew nigh to me, all right? And the angel of the
Spirit. Some are going to be already on the chariot.
See how it is given to
however the Lord does it, man.
And on thy account, power is given to the angel who is with thee. And I saw how my
but
Lord
we
and the
one.
Angel of the Spirit worship.
We are
and they
one.
Both
so
together
as
praise
we
God.
Are out preaching that. Hey, they're in the spiritual realm
worship.
Prophesying and preaching
and
too.
And the angels drew near.
Prove it. Let's
worship.
Prove it.
And all the angels prayed. All
right.
And thereupon I heard the voice.
So when we say the 144,
which I heard,
right,
heard
we ain't saying that all of them are right on the earth right
there.
Now. Some of them are in the heavens.
And all were being sent up to that glorious one whose glory I could not behold. And I myself was hearing and beholding the praise which was given to him.
This is Revelation
6. And the Lord
6.
And the angel of the Spirit were beholding all and hearing all. And all the praises which are sent up from the six heavens are not only heard, but seen.
And not.
And I heard the angel who conducted
the and when he had
me,
opened
he
the
said,
fifth seal, I
this
saw
is
under
the
altar
the
soul
of, pilot,
of them
dwelling
which were
in
slain
the Holy
for the word of God
and resting in his Holy
and for the testimony
who
which
will
they
be
held.
Called by the Holy Spirit.
All right, these are the men of the Lord
the righteous,
that had the new
the Father,
soul, right?
Of the Lord. And I heard the voice
that
of the Most High,
the
Father of my
the
Lord, saying to my
to
Lord Christ,
preach.
Who will be called Jesus,
right?
Go forth and descend to all the heavens, and thou wilt
descend where did he look
to the
at? Under the altar,
thou
now
world.
We know.
To the angel and Sheol
in the heavens,
without descend,
don't you
but
know
to
that
Haguel,
there's an altar?
Thou wilt not go.
There's a
and thou wilt become like unto the likeness of all
that's how Moses
five heavens.
Was able to get
and
the blueprint of how to create the earth
and form of the angels of the firmament,
right?
And the angel also
the altar
Sheol. And none right, of the angels
the
of that world shall
sacrifice.
Know that thou art with
there
me
are the
of the
souls.
Seven heavens and of their angels. And
right.
They shall not know that thou
so
art with
think.
Me, till with a loud
there's
voice
particular
I have called
souls
to the heavens
chosen by the
and their
high.
Angels and their right. Lights,
for
even
particular
unto
purpose,
the sixth
and they're
heaven,
like they're the first
in order
group.
That you mayest judge and destroy
the
princes
group.
And angels and gods of that
in
world.
In a carnal sense
the world that is
of your increase.
For they have
okay, in a carnal sense, you have the
we are alone and there is none beside us.
Of your first
and
after
from the angels of death, thou wilt descend to thy place,
planet,
and thou wilt not
you,
be transformed.
You know, bring it to the
heaven,
temple.
But in glory wilt thou
so
ascend.
So, in a spiritual sense, you have the first fruit.
And thereupon the princes
right,
and powers
the elect
world,
of the firstborn church, all of those spirits.
These commands I heard the great
right,
glory giving
were
to
chosen
my Lord.
To be meant to
and
be
so I
man,
saw my Lord go forth from the seventh heaven into the sixth heaven.
Okay.
And the angel who conducted
when they return to the heavens, they go and
said,
"I'm we're reading it.
Understand, Isaiah.
Okay.
See
I looked. I saw under the altar
the
souls
of
them that were slain for the word of God,
and I saw,
and for the testimony
the
which they held, and they cried with a loud voice, saying, How long, O Lord, holy
and
true, dost thou judge
and
avenge our blood on them that dwell on earth? So we're yearning for. They want the same thing in the spiritual realm.
And I saw when he descended into the fifth heaven, that in the fifth heaven he made himself like unto the form of the angels there.
Come on, man."
And they did not praise him, nor worship him.
Their white robes were given
his
unto
form
them.
Was like unto theirs.
Every one of them.
And then he descended into the fourth.
All right. And it was
made
said unto them
like
that they
unto
should
the
rest
of the angels
yet
there.
For a little season unto their
they
fellow servants.
They did
and
not
also
praise
their brethren
him,
that should be killed as they
like
were
unto their
to be fulfilled.
And
so
again, I saw when he
some
descended
of these spirits,
into the third heaven. And he made
right,
himself like unto the form of the angels.
To the earth and they're here now preaching.
And those who kept
okay,
the
but there's still some up there.
Demanded the password. And the Lord gave it
the
to
Lord,
him in order that he should not be
when,
recognized.
When he returned,
and when
gonna,
they saw him, they did not praise
first.
Or laud him, for his form was like unto their
okay.
form. And again, I saw when he descended
death,
into
the know,
second
for the word of the
and again, he gave
time,
the password there.
No such thing
those
as
who
death.
Kept the gate proceeded to
this
demand and
that there is no
give.
Such thing as death.
And I saw
were
when he made himself like
God,
unto the form of the angels in the second heaven. And they saw him and did not praise him, for his form was like unto their form. And again, I saw when he descended into the first heaven.
All
and
right.
there also he gave the password
so,
to those who kept the gate. And he made himself like
there's
unto the
be
form
some
of
in
the
this time that
were on the left of that
throne.
And they
that,
neither praised
know,
nor lauded him, for his
and,
form
and
was like
them.
Unto their form.
All right,
but
there's going to be some
no one asked
who are on
me
the earth
on of the angel
who are
going to
be beamed
me.
Up.
And again, he
right?
descended into the firmament where dwelleth the ruler of this world. And he gave the password to those who left. And his form was
in
like 14. Theirs.
Well, if we believe that Yahweh Shai died and rose again,
they were envying
even them also,
mother and fighting.
Which sleep in Yahweh Shai will God bring with him.
And envying about trifles.
For this we say,
and I saw when he descended
by,
and made himself
unto
like
you
unto
by
the
word
of
the Lord,
and
that
he
we
like
which are alive and remain,
and he gave no password,
until the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. And what
after
is he going to do
I
when he comes?
And the angel
he
spoke with
me,
he conducted, said unto me, Understand, Isaiah, son of Amoz, for for this purpose it I says, have been sent from God. And I indeed saw a woman of the family of David the prophet named Mary, a virgin.
So and those she was who were still alive on earth, Joseph, a carpenter.
And he also was of the seed and family of the righteous David of Bethlehem in Judah. And he came into his wife.
It says,
and when
for
she
the
was
Lord
espoused, she was found with child.
Shall descend from heaven with the shout of the voice of an archangel.
But the angel of the Spirit appeared in this world. And after that, Joseph did not put her away.
And that could be linked.
But kept Mary,
I love getting this
and did not reveal
this
matter to anyone.
Matthew, the 24th
and he did not approach Mary, but kept her as a whole virgin, though with child. And he did not live with her for 2 months.
He says that he shall send
and after 2 months of days, while Joseph was in his house, he married his wife,
together
but both alone. It came to pass that when they were alone, that Mary straightway looked with her eyes and saw a small babe, and she was astonished. And after she had been astonished, her womb was found as formerly before she had conceived. And when her husband Joseph said unto her, what is astonishing? His eyes were opened, and he saw the infant and praised God, because into his portion God has come. And a voice came to him, tell this vision to no one. And the story regarding the end of the noise of God.
We don't know how exactly it's going to all come together, but that's what Scripture says to know in part with prophesying.
And many said, she has not born a child, nor has a midwife gone up to her, nor have we heard the cries of labor
on earth amongst
them. And they were all blind respecting
him,
and they all knew regarding him, though they knew not whence he was.
But that means that we can't tell you exactly when, we can't tell you exactly how it's going to look.
And I saw Hezekiah and Josaph, my son, and I declared to the other prophets also who are standing by, if this hath escaped all the heavens and all the princes and all the gods of this world. All
right.
And I saw in
now, when you read Revelation
the
5th chapter,
and
okay,
as
it says that whole body,
that he might not be recognized.
144
and when he had grown up, he worked great signs and wonders in the land of Israel
praising
and
the Lord.
Jerusalem.
I
and after this, the adversary
look,
envied and roused the children of Israel against him,
can't
not knowing who he was. And they delivered him to the king
how tall
and crucified him. And he descended to the angel of Sheol. In Jerusalem, indeed, I saw him being crucified
He's
going to
be face to face with us.
And likewise, after the third day, rise again and remain
40 days. We'll know everything.
And the angel who conducted me said, understand, Isaiah. And I saw when he sent out the 12 apostles and ascended. And I saw, and he was in the firmament, but he had not changed himself into their form. And all the angels of the firmament and the Satan saw him, and they worshipped. And there was much sorrow there, while they said, how did our Lord descend in our midst, and we perceive not the glory which has been upon him, which we see has been upon him from the sixth heaven? And he ascended into the second heaven, and he did not transform himself, but all the angels who were on the right and on the left and the throne in the midst, both worshipped him and praised him and said, how did our Lord escape us whilst descending, and we perceive not?
To meet
and in
the
like
Lord
manner
in the
he
air,
ascended
so
into the third heaven, and they praised and said in like manner.
The Lord.
And in the fourth
so
heaven, and in the fifth also they said precisely after
the
same manner.
Okay?
But there was one glory, and from it he did not change himself.
Say,
and I saw when he ascended into the sixth heaven. And they worshiped and
hopefully
glorified
you were comforted
him.
By that.
But in all the heavens, the praise
because
increased.
If you are looking at this thing,
and I saw how he ascended
of,
into the seventh
man, we got it, you know,
and
the
all the righteous and all the angels praised
about,
him. And then I saw him sit down on the right hand of that great glory.
That ain't how we
should look
at this
world.
You know, ultimately,
and also
the
angel of the Holy Spirit I saw sitting on the left hand. And this angel said unto me, Isaiah, son of Amoz, it is enough for thee, for thou hast seen what no child of flesh hath seen.
So
now wilt return into thy
garden
of
the flesh,
until thy days are
completed,
then thou wilt
come hither.
These things Isaiah saw and told unto all that stood before him, and they praised. And he spake to Hezekiah the king and said, I have spoken these things. Both the end of this world and all this vision will be consummated in the last generations. And Isaiah made him swear that he would not tell it to the people of Israel, nor give these words to any man to transcribe such things as ye will read. And watch ye in the Holy Spirit in order that ye may receive your garments and thrones and crowns of glory, which are laid up in the seventh heaven. On account of these visions and prophecies, Samael, Satan, sawed in sunder Isaiah, the son of Amoz the prophet, by the hand of Manasseh. And all these things Hezekiah delivered to Manasseh in the 26th year. But Manasseh did not remember them nor place these things in his heart. But becoming a servant of Satan, he was destroyed. Here endeth the vision of Isaiah the prophet with his ascension.